So the topic is the new chapter of Vijayanagara and Bahamini kingdoms. So I have already discussed regarding administration, economy, and industry and trade. Now I will discuss regarding the art and architecture in this chapter. The Vijayanagara rulers were great builders, and the period saw the reveal of regional art, architecture, and literature. The rulers built many temples and palaces, the most famous being the Vithalaswamy Temple and the Hazara Rama Temple. The temples were adorned with beautiful sculptures. They also rebuilt some temples built by the Cholas. According to Dominga Pace, Vijayanagara was surrounded by seven walls covering an area of about 96 kilometers. Inside the city, there were beautiful gardens, lakes, palaces, temples, and their buildings. People were fond of jewelry, diamonds, rubies, emeralds, and pearls were sold in the bazaar. It means market. Piles compared Vijayanagara or to the city of Rome. The Vijayanagara rulers were great patrons of learned, mean Telugu, Kannada, Kannad, it means, and Sanskrit flourished. Work on reason, philosophy, and law were rewritten. Clear? So, a long poem in Telugu. Amutkama Laida, a long poem in Telugu which explains how a king should rule was composed by Krishna Deva Raya. His court had eight great Telugu scholars of the Astha Digga, clear? Of whom Tenali Rama, Pedana, and Madhava are famous. The Vijayanagara rulers also patronized saints like Janaveda, and Namaveda painting, music, and dance also flourished. Social and religious customs. The Vijayanagara ruled followed Hinduism added Vedic customs. They were governed by religious norms and gave a lot of importance to the Brahmins. The caste system was followed. They were, however, tolerant of other religions and did not discriminate between Christians, Jews, Muslims, and Hindus. It means Hinduism. Women were respected and some even occupied high position in political life. However, their freedom was restricted. So the women's are respected, were respected, and some even occupied high position in a political life. So, however, their freedom was restricted. Sati Pratha was practiced. Polygamy and child marriage were also prevalent. Sacrifice or yajnas were performed routinely. Bahmani Kingdom. The Bahmani Kingdom was established in 1347 CE. Who ruled from 1347 CE to 1537 CE? Bahman Shah, Muhammad Shah, I Muhammad Shah II, Muhammad Shah I, and Muhammad Shah II. Firoz Shah, Ahmad Shah, and Alauddin II were some of the important rulers of the Bahmani Kingdom. Who? The four rulers: Muhammad Shah I, Bahman Shah, Muhammad Shah II, Firoz Shah, Ahmad Shah, and Alauddin II were some of the important rulers of the Bahmani Kingdom. It means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There were 18 rulers. There were 18 rulers of the Bahmani Kingdom from 1340 CE to 1537 CE. Bahman Shah, Muhammad Shah, Muhammad Shah II, Firoz Shah, Ahmad Shah, and Alauddin II were some of the important rulers of the Bahmani Kingdom. So the Bahmani kingdom was established 1347 CE by Hasan Gangu, who took the name Alauddin Bahman Shah as his title. The most important line, the Bahmani kingdom was established in 1347 CE by Hasan Gangu, who took the name Alauddin Bahman Shah as his title. He brought the rebellious nobles under his control and established peace and an efficient administration. The kingdom extended from the Arabian Sea in the west to the Bay of Bengal in the east. Muhammad Shah first. So who was Muhammad Shah? Muhammad Shah first was the eldest son of Jafar Khan. Muhammad Shah first, eldest son of Jafar Khan. He waged wars against the Vijayanagar and Warangal kingdoms and defeated them. He also put down lawlessness with a heavy hand. Now, Firoz Shah Bahmani. Firoz Shah, he ruled from 1397 to 1422 CE and was the eighth ruler of the dynasty. He defeated the Vijayanagar kings in two major battles, but when he lost the third one in 1422 CE, he was forced to step down from the throne in favor of his brother. Ahmad Shah not only avenged his brother defeat but ransacked the city of Vijayanagar. He also transferred the capital from Gulbarga to Bidar. Muhammad Ghan, 1463 to 1481 CE. Muhammad Ghan, who was Muhammad Ghan, a Persian merchant. Muhammad Ghan was a Persian merchant, came to India in 1460. He took service under the Bahmani ruler Alauddin II in 1453 CE. He became the prime minister when Muhammad Shah III was crowned Sultan at the age of 9. He became the prime minister when Muhammad Shah III was crowned Sultan at the age of 9. He served as a master with devotion and loyalty. A man of few needs, he helped the poor with his savings. He defeated the ruler of Konkan and Orissa and captured Dabhol and Goa from Vijayanagar. He also defeated the ruler of Warangal, an efficient administrator. He introduced several reforms. And the kingdom was divided into eight provinces or Tarafs. Taraf means provinces under the Bahmani rulers. The revenue system was also reorganized to the able to generate enough money to enable them to maintain a strong army. Madrasas were built for Islamic learning in Bidar. The Deccan nobles disliked Ghan and were jealous of him. So they conspired against him and got him exhausted in 1481 CE. Soon after this, the Bahmani kingdom began to decline. It was divided into five independent states, namely Birar, Bijapur, Bidar, Ahmednagar, and Golconda. They were constantly at war with each other and were later absorbed by the Mughals. Contribution of the Bahmani kingdom. The Bahmani kingdom rulers were patrons of art and architecture, language, literature, and music. Urdu developed under their patronage. Many scholars lived in their courts. In the field of architecture, the Gol Gumbaz in Bijapur is famous and has a dome which is 53.4 meters high. The Golconda rulers also built the Charminar at Hyderabad. Where is Charminar? It is situated in Hyderabad. Clear? So, Muhammad Khan built the madrasas at Bidar, which is a three-storied building and could house a thousand students, many students from Iran and the Iraq come to study there. The other famous monuments are the Jama Masjid at Gulbarg, the fort of Golconda and the tomb of Ahmad Shah at Bidar. The Gol Gumbaz has the second largest dome in the world. Clear? The Gol Gumbaz has the second largest dome in the world. The largest being that of St. Peter's in Rome. The acoustic system. The acoustic system is a marvel of engineering. Acoustic means related to sound or eco-hearing. According to related to sound or hearing. Clear? So the finest whisperer around the dome is carried around the dome and returns to the person 9 times. So